A young adult presented himself in a clinic. He explained that he has non-itchy skin rashes and sores on some parts of his body, including his mouth, throat, and genitals. Doctor asked him about when he first noticed the symptoms. He replied that he noticed the symptoms about 2 months ago, when it started with a painless sore. He is worried that it may be something that he got because of being sexually active recently. After thorough examination, the doctor noticed bald patches had appeared on different parts of his head, and his lymph nodes became swollen. The doctor sent the man's blood to the laboratory for diagnosis. The diagnosis result confirmed his fear. The man was suffering from a bacterial disease called syphilis. Syphilis is a primarily sexually transmitted disease passed on to a partner by a person infected with Treponema pallidum. Treponema pallidum is a spirochete, which is a corkscrew-shaped bacterium. It can transmit asexually too, from mother to infant and through blood transfusion. It can also transmit asexually in communities living under poor hygienic conditions. Syphilis can be diagnosed through blood or serum of the patient by enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay, ELISA, and venereal disease research laboratory, VDRL test, along with some other tests. ELISA checks for antibodies of the bacteria in the blood, while VDRL detects antibodies in the blood of the patient by using a cholesterol antigen. This method is also known as VDRL antigen in an alcoholic solution. The signs and symptoms of syphilis occur in three stages. These stages are as follows. Stage 1. About 3 weeks after infection, a painless sore appears at the site where the bacteria have entered the body. In men, it usually occurs on the penis, and for women, it happens within the vagina or on the cervix. The sore may disappear in a few weeks, even without treatment. Stage 2. About 2 to 6 months after infection, signs appear on different parts of the body, such as non-itchy skin rashes and sores that are located on the mouth, throat, and genitals. The sores are called chancres. Bald patches may also appear on the head. The lymph glands may become inflamed. These signs again disappear after some time, but the bacteria remain dormant in the body if not treated until the third stage of the disease. Stage 3. In the third stage, the internal organs become affected. This is the most advanced and final stage of the disease. Patients may suffer from heart failure and blindness. The brain and spinal cord may be damaged, resulting in paralysis, insanity, and even death. Syphilis could be cured at all stages if prompt treatment is sought. Now, can you guess which stage the man was on when he presented himself in the clinic? The doctor immediately contacted the man and prescribed him antibiotics, in this case, penicillin. He also asked him to refrain from intercourse and trace contacts with whom he had intercourse so that they can be treated promptly. This will reduce chances of an epidemic. He also advised the man to limit sexual partners to just one and wear a condom during intercourse.
Thank you for your continuous support, especially our valued patrons and members who have been encouraging us to keep producing more quality content.